massive decision to be made. Choose wisely. To find America's next, the final apron goes to MasterChef. Right.
Yeah.
We've got,
yeah, most of it on the table.
Two apron's left. Two. I've got three. One of us is going to find America's next MasterChef. That's right. Let the battle begin.
First up are two talented home cooks who hope to win a white apron.
Coming out with apron for sure.
By putting their own twist.
Oh, yummy tomato, Annabelle.
Fried chicken recipes.
It's unreal. You know it is.
Yeah. My name is Farhan. I'm 25 years old. I live in Chicago, Illinois, and I'm a third year dental student. So my dad is only a series of water rooms. This is not really where my mother came from.
This is my funny captain.
I want to combine American dishes and change them up by using Indian flavor. And I think that's what's really going to set me apart.
My name is Gerard. I'm 25 years old. I'm from Louisville, Kentucky. I'm an English teacher. I have seven siblings. I'm the first person in my family to go to a four-year college and graduate. Growing up in a rough neighborhood, cooking for me was a way out. And that's exactly the opportunity that I want to provide for my students.
MasterChef is going to give me the platform to show America what Indian food is all about.
Welcome, guys.
Oh, my goodness.
Indian can really be the next Tex-Mex. All that needs to happen is it needs to be packaged in the perfect way, and I'm the person to have that.
Both of you, welcome to the MasterChef Kitchen.
Thank you.
Now, to take a place in the MasterChef competition, you only have to impress one of us. And if you have what it takes to get more than one offer, then it's up to you to choose who you want to be your mentor.
But if he's not, you'll pick me.
So it looks like we have a fried chicken cook-off coming our way.
Fried chicken challenge.
You have 45
minutes. Yummy tomatoes.
Time starts now.
Let's go for how
let's
turn
do it
up.
Baby. Making that online marinade. What about you,
brother? Hey, y'all over here making my fry for my Nashville chicks. We're going to turn it up. Skin.
You put a little camaraderie between both of them. They're nice, likable guys. But here's the deal. I need a whole bunch of killer instincts, creativity, heart, and we're going to take risks. My friends are going to people who already have great palates, abundant food knowledge, and real technique in the kitchen.
They're totally different from me, don't they? I'm the students. As long as they're willing to learn, I'm willing to teach them.
Our little like shiny dots means you're in focus.
Yes, sir.
What's in that?
This is actually my dad's secret tandoori chicken blend. I've adapted it to be buttermilk instead of yogurt, and it's my mom's cilantro.
I can monitor the audio.
And we're gonna fry that up on a buttermilk biscuit.
Color.
So it's my family story coming to America on a plate.
Your story sounds extremely similar to mine. I'd love to hear it.
Trust me, Ron. I've been watching you on TV since I was a little boy, so this is a dream come true.
I appreciate it. Good luck.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, 25 minutes remaining.
Yes, Chef.
Thank you, Chef.
John, give us an insight to what you're making.
Yes, Chef. I'm making a Nashville hot chicken with a vinaigrette-based slaw and also a sweet heat sauce. It's my mother's recipe, and so the way we traditionally do it is a paper bag, and you season the flour to give you that Nashville smoky, sweet, and spicy.
Gentlemen, 10 minutes left. The last 10 minutes you have to finish your dishes. The spices in this kitchen are intoxicating. It smells awesome. I've had fried chicken 1,000 times, but Farhan's tandoori chicken sounds amazing. Just over 90 seconds to go. Farhan's very busy now.
That's a good biscuit.
60 seconds. There's a lot on the line tonight.
Charlie, got this, brother.
Got this, Charlie.
Got it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and stop, hands in the air, well done.
Right,
gentlemen, bring your dishes down to the front, please. Let's go. Let's taste them. So, Farhan, tell me what's in that dish.
What we have here is my dad's tandoori chicken recipe on a black pepper buttermilk biscuit with my mom's cilantro chutney and a tamarind honey butter.
What should it look like inside?
So the chicken should be nice and moist and juicy. Hopefully you see it nice and glisten.
Mm.
That is one of the best things I've ever tasted in this kitchen. The texture from the coconut, it works beautifully with the floral nature of the cilantro. That chicken is moist, and none of the spices are competing with one another.
Thank you, chef.
I love it. It's so nice to see that Indian culture blending into the American. You know, great job.
Thank you, sir.
Careful with this one, they're small. You have to bite in half. Yeah, bite it in half.
Young man, describe this, please.
Yeah.
This is a Nashville hot chicken.
Actually, bit it in half.
With the green cabbage and a red cabbage slaw made with a vinaigrette and a sweet heat sauce.
She has mother. Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry.
You feel you have to spice the others or to your own taste?
So for me, chef, I spice to others' taste. But when you eat a Nashville hot piece of chicken, you expect it to be hot, chef.
It's good.
Thank you, chef.
But this is good, too.
Give her a grape.
I want some of you. Really want.
Just put it in her mouth.
I'm hungry.
She doesn't aim well, and then she slips and drops it. Now she never does that.
Yeah.
Unless she aims like really well.
Remember, we started out with 8 aprons each. So we must be absolutely certain on who we choose. You both could leave here tonight, eh? Or you may both end up empty-handed. Or three of us might offer you an apron. If that happens, it's down to you guys to decide who you want to mentor you throughout this whole competition.
With that said, Joe, our two phenomenal performances.
And do we have to give an apron? I like both of you, but today I'd like to offer.
She takes food on the floor and puts it back in her mouth.
No, it's on the table.
Yeah. I thought she was done with that.
What I like about you is you have the hunger.
Thank you, chef.
Fine, over to you, Laurent.
Very important. You've got a great foundation, but you've got a long way to go. And I
Annabelle. Annabelle. Come here. Come here, Annabelle.
Just reach out and put your hand on the apron of the chef that you decide will be your mentor.
Annabelle. Come here. Come here, Annabelle.
Sorry, Gordon. No hard feelings.
So, what do you think, Jeff?
Well, first of all, I'm delighted. It was a tough decision. Both of you put a great foot forward, and you're gonna get someone that's gonna be with you every step of the way.
Well done, you two. But you got the worst two mentors you could have picked.
Annabelle.
Good night.
Well done.
Thank you.